Hello everyone, today we're going birding. We need to find Uncle. Where is Uncle?
Is Uncle up in the trees?
No, Uncle's not a bird.
Is that Uncle over there? Let's take a closer look.
No, that's not Uncle.
It might look like Uncle, but it's not.
Let's keep looking around. Where could Uncle be?
Is that Uncle over there?
No.
Is he over there?
No.
Let's keep looking around for Uncle. We need to find him so we can go birding. When you see Uncle, let me know where Uncle is.
There he is!
But it seems Uncle is sleeping on the hammock. We need to wake him up. To wake him up, let's say, "Wake up, Uncle!" Okay, let's say it together. 1, 2, 3. Wake up, Uncle! Let's say it louder. 1, 2, 3. Wake up, Uncle! Let's do it one more time. 1, 2, 3. Wake up, Uncle!
Who said that? Who said that? Oh, there you are. Good morning. We're gonna go birding today. So, let's get ready.
See my mama in a minute. On my heart just like a pendant. I hate thinking about the shit. It's like a domino. Black spots up in my memory. I white out all the pain with green. That's the only color that ain't done me wrong.
Damn, how I'm home with these niggas. With these home with these niggas. Is you an R&B nigga? So I'ma gotta know. Smitty J, she doing goody. Had our meals off in a hoodie. Made a meal off of a hoodie.
Stacking on satin wool. Stacking on satin wool. I caught a flight from the loo to the west side. 40 feet, look at me, mama, I'm fly.
Okay, so before we go birding, we need to know a little bit more about birds. Okay, so here's a little graph of what a bird looks like, right? And the parts we want to learn today is very simple. So they have their head and they have their body, right? So on the head, they're going to have a chin. This is the bird's chin. Okay, this is the bird's chin here. Awesome. Now, they also have what is called a crown. And a crown is, you know, like a king. It's gonna go on their little head. Perfect. Apart from the crown, there is the throat. The throat is this part. Okay, this is the throat. So this is what a throat looks like on a little bird. Now, there's also the breast. The breast is in front where their lungs are, right? So this is the breast area. This is the breast of a bird. Okay. Also, there is the nape. Nape is back here. Atrasito de su pescuezo. Apart from that, there is the back of the bird. And that's su espalda. That's the back of a bird. And also, there is a rump. And a rump is por su nalguita. Okay? So that's the parts that we're going to be learning today. And I'm going to show you some birds in El Rancho that have these parts. Okay? So let's go.
Okay, we're going to go birding. But remember, whenever we go birding, we need to carry our binos, right? And whenever I say, "Where's your binos?" you do this, right? With your two hands. So where's your bino? And we're going to be looking for birds. We're going to see a lot of different birds today, and, you know. I can already hear some, so let's go.
Let's go. Did you hear that? That sounds like the scarlet-rumped tanager. Do you see it? Shh, let's listen. Let's listen. Okay, if you hear it again, you know, remember, I'll say, "Where's your bino?" and you pull up your binos, okay? We're looking for the scarlet-rumped tanager. And in its back, por su nalguita, It has scarlet, which looks like red. There it is! Where's your bino?
Awesome. So here we have the scarlet rum tanager. And as you can see by its nalguita, it is scarlet. Yeah, it's a scarlet rum tanager. Really cool. And here we have the female scarlet rum tanager. As you can see, it's not as pretty as the male one, but it's still as cool. It's not as bright. And she's looking around, and she fly away. Now let's look back at our little friend. Who is this over here? Mr. Cotimundi, you're not a bird. No, 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 no. Silly Cotimundi, are you looking for coconuts? That's what you're looking for. But let's go back to our friend over here, the scarlet rumped tanager. Bien bonito, bien cute. Look at it go. It's gonna fly away as well. Awesome. Let's look at other birds.
That was really cool. So, let's look out for another bird and have your ears ready. Because the next bird does like this. So when you listen to it, you tell me, okay? Ahí está. There. Okay? And we're going to look for it. So let me tell you what it looks like. This bird really likes acorn. And that's why it's called an acorn woodpecker. Right? It does little holes on the wood. And then it stores an acorn there so he can eat it later. Lo come más al rato porque he's not hungry anymore. For later. Okay? And when you save food for later, save it for uncle because I'm always hungry. But besides that, the acorn woodpecker has a red crown. Remember, the crown is on the head. So, it's also white and it's also black. But it has a very, very red head. Right? Red crown. So the acorn woodpecker, Rommel and his friend were saying that it looks like a penguin. But it's not a penguin. No, 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 no. It's not a penguin. You hear that? Where's your bino?
Okay, awesome. So here we have the acorn woodpecker. As I said earlier, they're mainly red, black, and white. And the males have a little bit of yellow. When you see an acorn woodpecker, normally you'll see not one, but multiple of them because they are very social. And also remember, they're very good at storing their food. And they put it on a tree, they do a lot of holes, and they come back later. Look at them go, they're so cool. And yeah, that's the acorn woodpecker.
Okay, perfect. So now we're gonna be looking for manakins. Wait, where's Uncle? ¿Dónde está Uncle? Whoa! Did I scare you? So let me show you something that's very, very cool. A different part of a bird, and this is called a thigh. So this is a thigh, see? The part of your leg, tu piernita. So let me show you here on the bird chart. So this is the thigh. Kind of like the bird's pantalones, its little pants. So funny. Okay? So that's what we're going to be doing. It's called the thigh. Now, there is these cool birds that are called manakins. And manakins, there's two in Belize. There's the red-capped manakin. The capped is su cabecita. It's a little head. That's a cap. And also the white colored manakin. And I have a picture here and I'll show you. So, take a look. See, this one is called the red capped manakin because it has red on its head. That's a cap. Black on its body. And funny enough, it has little yellow pantalones. See, the little yellow pantalones. It's so funny. Oh my gosh, so funny. Okay. And then, so that's the red capped manakin. Now, this is called a white-collared manakin because it has white on its collar. To give you an idea of what a collar is, look at this. Okay? This could be a collar. If I put it on my neck, that's a collar because it goes all around my neck. Okay? That's a white-collared manakin. Now, they do very interesting little noises. Okay? The white-collared manakin does something that's called lekking. What is lekking? Lekking is a mechanical sound that they do by using their wings, and it's done like this. So that's lekking. Now, there's also something called wing sonations. What is that, Uncle? Well, wing sonations is a little bit more like this. So we're going to be listening for the manakins. Remember, there's the red cat manakin with its red cap. or the white colored, which has a white color, right? So let's listen. ¿Dónde están? When you hear them, tell me, Uncle, ahí está, there it is. Where's your bino?
Okay, peepers, snippers, weepers, Ibicha Liani. Take a look at the red cap mannequin. It's very small, but it's still very cute, just like you two. And if you see, its body is almost all black. And it also has other colors, which is red on its head and also yellow on its thighs. Remember, its thighs look like pantalones. So funny. Now, apart from that, I'm gonna show you something very, very cool. The red cap mannequin likes to dance! Cuela máquina, it likes to dance. And it goes tick 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 left. Go tick 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 right. So I'm gonna show you and take a look at this next video.
Okay, let's talk about... Wait, where's Uncle? Let's talk about another bird. And there's another part of the bird that I want to show you. Look at this. Let's look at the bird chart. So, this is the thigh, and this is a leg, okay? So, there's another really, really cool bird around that is called a red-legged honey creeper. So cool. And it's funny because it is blue and black. And where do you think the red is? Remember, it's called a red-legged honey creeper. Is the red on its head? No. On its wing? No. Wrong. It's on the leg. That's why it's called a red-legged honey creeper. So, take a look around, okay? If you hear a sound, remember, tell me, Uncle, ahí está. There it is. Ahí está! Where's your bino?
Alright, perfect. Now we're gonna be seeing the red-legged honey creeper. And oh my gosh, it's very, very cute. Look at it. It's mainly blue all over its body. And it has black wings. And if you are very careful, you can see that its little head, you can see it there, it's turquoise. It's like very light blue and it's very, very pretty. And right there is why they call it a red-legged honey creeper. You see its legs are red. Now it's looking around for food, possibly. It's cleaning its little beak. So cute, look at it. Oh my gosh. Do you want to see one as well? So pretty, right? Oh, it's se está rascando. It's probably itchy a little bit. So cool. Alright, let's go on to the next bird.
Okay, awesome. That was a really cool bird, right? So, I want to tell you a story when I went birding with Rommel. So, what happened is we went to Pine Ridge and wait a minute, where are you? Are you in the trees? Where are you? You're hiding somewhere. No.
Hiding.
Oh, there you are. You're hiding behind a tree. Let's go. And let me tell you a story about when I went bird watching with Rommel and we went to Pine Ridge. So we were walking and walking and walking, and then Rommel suddenly says, stop! Do you see that over there? Well, it's not over there, right? But Rommel said, it's over there. And I was like, what are you looking at? You're crazy. Y él me dijo, no, I'm not crazy. Look. And then we saw this bird. It's called a white-necked puffbird. So see its neck? It's white, so all around it's white. It's an infly, it does like this. It's a white puff, white neck puff bird. So remember, when you hear a sound, say, ahí está, there it is, okay? Did you hear something? Did you? Where's your bino?
Awesome, so this is the white neck puff bird, and it's a bit chunky. And normally it's by itself, perched in a branch. And remember that story I told you about Rommel finding that bird? It was very cool because you know, it wasn't moving. It wasn't making noise. It was just perched on the tree. So we were very lucky to have Rommel. And that was what we call a lifer when you see it for the first time in your life. So that was a really cool day in Mountain Pine Ridge.
Okay, so come look at this. I'll show you my motorcycle. That's me, bear. Very cute. Do you think it's lovely? Yes, it's lovely. Do you think it's lovely? Yes. Okay, so it's a red motorcycle. No. I trick you. It's a blue motorcycle and it's lovely. So there's a bird and I'll show you. Come here. Look at this. It's called a lovely cotinga. And it's just like my motorcycle, see? It's a lovely cotinga. And it doesn't make any sound. So the lovely cotinga is very, very silent. So if you're not paying attention, you'll miss it, okay? So let's look around. Do you see a lovely cotinga? Do you see lovely cotinga? Huh? Did you see that? Where's your bino?
So beautiful. Look at the lovely cotinga. It's blue and it has like a purple heart shape on its chest. Remember, it's very quiet, so you'll often miss it if you're not paying attention. So pretty. Okay, perfect. Now, I hope you enjoyed, you know, doing a little bird watch with me. Now, we're going to go over some of the birds that we already saw. And this is the first one that I said that looks like a penguin, but it's not a penguin. Do you remember its name? Remember, it likes to eat acorns. And it's a woodpecker, right? It pecks on wood until it makes a hole. So if you combine the name, it's called an acorn woodpecker. Okay, awesome. Now we're going to go over two of the mannequins that we saw. Now, the first one that I have on screen right now, it is a mannequin. And what color is this part? Remember, it's a cap. So the color is red. So it's called a red-capped mannequin, right? One more time. It's called a red-capped mannequin. That's good. That's right. The red-capped mannequin is very pretty because it has a red cap, black body, and it has yellow pantalones on its thigh. Awesome. Let's go to the next one. Awesome. So this one is a mannequin as well. Remember, although it has yellow on its belly, black on its back and head, and orange feet, this has what color on its neck? Is it blue, purple, black? No. It has white, right? So this is a white-colored mannequin because it has a white collar. So the color goes all around its neck. Let's say it one more time. White-colored mannequin. Very good. This is a white-colored mannequin. Good job. Let's see the next bird. Okay, do you remember this one? Remember, this is a honey creeper. And the name comes from its leg. So what color is the leg? It's red, right? So it's a red-legged honey creeper. It has a blue on its head, on its chest, and also on its belly. And its wings are black, and it has a very beautiful turquoise crown. Remember, the crown is what goes on the head. So that part, or this part here, on top, this is the crown, and it's turquoise. It's like light blue, and it's very, very beautiful. So let's go over the name. Remember, it's a red-legged honey creeper. One more time. A red-legged honey creeper. Okay, you got that? Awesome. I'm glad you enjoyed the red-legged honey creeper. Let's go on to the next one. Awesome. So remember, this bird is a puff bird, and the name comes from its neck. So what color is its neck? It's white. So this is a white-necked puff bird. It's a very silent one as well. So you gotta be careful so you don't miss it. Okay, let's go over its name one more time. Remember, it's a white-necked puff bird. So what is its name? It's a white-necked puff bird. Good job. Now for the last one, this is a very rare bird. And I'm very excited about this one. So remember, this is a very lovely bird. Lovely just like my blue motorcycle. So this is a cotinga, and its name is a lovely cotinga. And one of its most identifying feature is the heart shape that it has on its chest, which is very cool because it's purple. And, you know, it complements the blue part on its body. So a very, very beautiful bird. And I hope you enjoyed going on this, again, a little birding adventure with me. I hope you had fun. And remember, I love you so, so much. And let's go birding again, okay? Bye-bye.
For the feet, look at me. Mama, I'm fly. Really can't catch a break, need to kick it. I put that chocolate light in the light. Ooh. You remind me of my cool. Gas me up good, pass me a wood. I roll up my insecure.